web causing heightened internet security concerns.
And the world's largest automaker recalls over 6 million vehicles. Humber News starts now.
Hello, it's Wednesday, April 9th. Welcome to Humber News, coming to you from the Broadcast Center here at the North Campus. I'm Kaya Welsh. Thanks for joining us.
And I'm Josh McConnell. Ahead on our show, we have all your news, sports, and entertainment highlights, as well as your five-day weather forecast. But first, Kaya has our top story.
The Heartbleed bug has led to security breaches on several websites, including the Canada Revenue Agency. Humber News reporter Charlotte Anquetel has more on how to protect yourself online.
If you're like most students here at Humber, you've probably logged on to your email, favorite website, or online banking at some point today. But at what cost to your personal security? A vulnerability called the Heartbleed bug is impacting some of the most commonly used websites in the world.
A lot of hackers and criminals, what they want to do is they want to find some way of getting in, either using authentic credentials, which they might steal from you, or figuring out some problem with the way that they're doing their authentication.
The Canada Revenue Agency is just one of the websites that has shut down public access, posting your statement. Please be assured that we are fully engaged in resolving this matter and restoring online services as soon as possible, in a manner that ensures the private information of Canadians remains safe and secure. Although it may not guarantee full security, experts are advising users to change their passwords for things like email, banking, and PayPal.
Your password is the only thing that keeps people out of your Facebook account or your OneDrive account, in this case here, your taxes. Make sure that password is a good one and don't recycle them.
The threat is particularly serious because it went undetected for more than 2 years. But a software fix was released Monday for companies that use the affected software. Charlotte Anquetel, Humber News.
Thanks, Charlotte. Toyota is recalling nearly 6.4 million vehicles, including more than 500,000 here in Canada. The recall comes after reports of 2 fires linked to a defective engine starter. It covers about 30 Toyota models produced from April 2004 through August 2013. Some affected models include Corolla, Yaris, and the Urban Cruiser. Other recalls include 2.32 million vehicles over problems with seat rails, some 760,000 vehicles because of a potential defect with a steering column bracket, and nearly 160,000 vehicles to replace the windshield wiper motors. The company says there have been no injuries or crashes reported.
2 firefighters have suffered non-life-threatening injuries after battling a blaze just before 8 this morning. The fire broke out in the basement of a townhouse on Perth Avenue north of DuPont Street. The division commander says one of the firefighters was taken to hospital to treat a leg injury. The injury was sustained after the floor collapsed, sending the firefighters tumbling into the basement. A Mayday signal was immediately sent out, and additional aid was sent to the scene after the status of the fire was raised to third alarm.
One man is in custody after a stabbing left 4 people injured. They were taken to Sunnybrook Hospital. 2 have serious injuries. The incident happened this morning on the 5th floor of the Yonge Corporate Center close to York Mills subway station. Police say an office employee attacked the victims with what appears to be scissors and was arrested at the scene. Southbound lanes of Yonge Street have since been closed at Highway 401. The motive for the attack is still unknown.
With exams just around the corner, students are gearing up to squeeze in all the cramming they can. And Humber is doing everything they can to relieve the stress. Andrea Fernandez has more on the story.
The race is on to the end of the school year, and the stress is at an all-time high with exams approaching. Students all around campus are experiencing frustration, fatigue, and just flat-out exhaustion. Jill Thornley, a general arts and health science student, says she has been cramming and is really feeling the pressure.
Getting to the point where I know I'm tired and I'm reading the same paragraph over and over, I know to call it a night, even if I don't feel prepared, because you can always wake up tomorrow.
But Humber College is making sure to equip the students with all kinds of resources to battle the exam stress. From free massages to manicures to oxygen bars, students are getting the chance to relax, unwind, and clear their mind, even if it's just for a couple of minutes. Jackie Dioki, massage therapist, says it's important to take time for yourself and for your body.
Take time out for yourself, even if it is 5 minutes every few hours, just to stretch out your neck, back, and shoulders.
Humber is providing students with all kinds of methods to relieve the stress. Andrew Fernandez, Humber News.
Thanks, Andrea. Recent grads are having a hard time finding jobs, and it's not due to a lack of skills. A McLean's report says recent grads are lacking the experience employers want. Many of the entry-level job postings are asking for 2 to 5 years of experience, something many grads don't have. A researcher with the Ontario Government Agency says employers are not willing to train new employees. The report says internships are another way to get experience.
Today marks the 7th annual International Day of Pink, a day that brings awareness to bullying in the LGBTQ community. The day is marked by wearing pink. Toronto Police Chief Bill Blair, school board officials, and members of the police services joined one of the largest gatherings celebrating diversity at Oakwood Collegiate. The initiative began in 2007 when a gay student from a Nova Scotia high school was bullied for wearing a pink shirt. Two other students intervened by getting everyone to wear pink shirts.
When we come back, we'll have more news from across the country and around the world. Jake Quarterpat will have the sports news, and we'll have your weather forecast with Julia Grabowska.
The sun is out and the skies are blue. I'll have your weather forecast for you after the break.